Marches and protests were held all across the country in all major cities. Millions showed up at Washington, D.C. to speak out against guns and to make sure we get some kind of gun control after the shooting that was held in Florida recently at that high school. And of course, all these marches were started and led by the high school students from that school. Awesome story. However, I learned some disturbing things on this particular day. Now, number one, let me confess that I am the owner of an AR-15. This is the very gun that was used by the shooter in Florida. It's been used in a couple of other mass shootings. It's not the primary weapon used in mass shootings, but it's certainly been involved. And let me say, I love my gun. I purchased it legally, went through background checks, paid my own hard-earned money for it. I'm a taxpayer. I am a contributor to not just the government, but charities. I'm a good person. I've never committed a violent crime. I love my gun, love shooting it. Yet, in spite of all that, I learned this weekend that, number one, I have blood on my hands. You see, the fact that I own that gun makes me a part of the mass shooting guilt. Even worse, as long as I maintain possession of that gun, I learned that I desire the deaths of future children. Yeah, I never knew. And so we got to pass laws to take this gun away, to make sure there is a ban on the sale and use of this rifle and like rifles forevermore, because that will save lives. And so if I'm not willing to surrender it at some point, it will be confiscated. And you know, never mind that we have an amendment, a right given to us by our forefathers that I can own and bear guns. So cast all that aside. It will save lives, right? Well, it appears American people are believing this rhetoric. Most are in favor of some of the things these kids want to see happen. And so, you know, the question I've been asked for years is, Bill, why do you need a gun like that? You know, come on. It's meant to kill people. Okay, yeah, but I really enjoy it. I like shooting it. I target practice with it, practice all the safety rules, never been a violent threat to anyone. But let me give you one clear reason why I don't want to give up my gun. And it's this. I was in Jerusalem a couple of years ago, and I toured the Holocaust Museum there. And I tell you what, if you're weak of heart, you do not need to go in that building. But there's one section of that museum, several rooms, dedicated to the Jewish resistance to the Nazis. It is the most pathetic display I've ever seen of anything in my life. You see, they had marches too. They were being marched to their deaths, men, women, and children, herded through streets, pushed into trains where they went off to be gassed. And the question you ask as you see all these pictures is, why didn't they fight back? Why didn't they do something? And where were the guns? Well, German men, many of them Jews who fought in World War I, part of their severance when the war was over with, was they got to keep their equipment, including their weapons. When Hitler took power, he made sure all these weapons were registered. You know, government's got to know. And then, of course, he knew what was going to happen to the Jews and ultimately passed a law to make sure all the guns were taken from the Jews specifically. So they were confiscated by those guys in brown uniforms. So they had no way to fight back. One of the most pitiful pictures I've ever seen is one of the leaders of the resistance for the Jews back in that day. It shows a picture of him holding just a little pistol. They'd taken it off a German soldier somewhere. And it's just pathetic thinking that's what they had to fight with against the power of the German army. You know what? Thanks, but no thanks. I'm going to keep my AR-15, and I'm grateful that millions of other Americans own this gun too. So I just need to know, how will you confiscate my gun when that day comes?